All right. Can y'all hear me? One, two, check one, two. Sure, I'm good on my levels.
Sounds good, Kenrick.
Sounds good. Okay. I'm assuming everybody's on mute, right? Oh, yes. Thank you, Pam. Thank you. You can hear me. All right. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, friends, colleagues, teachers. Welcome, 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 welcome. I feel so good and so blessed to be in this position to share with you my knowledge, experiences. We got a lot to talk. We have a lot to talk about today, but we only have about an hour, so we're going to get into it. And the name of this is "What Do We Tell the Kids?" And looking at through hip hop through the lens of oppression, right? How do we, how do we as hip hop performers, speak our truth, speak our pain through music? And what I would like to do with you all today is I'm going to kind of train your ears to listen in. I'm going to train your ears to listen in to the words of our people, in particular verses, beats, and then we're going to explore that a little bit, and we're going to unpack where we can. I do believe there may be a little bit of an audio situation going on, but we'll see what we could do. We'll try to work with what we have. So let's go ahead. Yeah, and start with that screen right there, and keep it right there for a second. As you can see, this is a graphic that I found that really kind of speaks about music and oppression in a way, depending on how you interpret it visually. But I saw it and I was like, this is actually a really good artwork, and I don't know who it's by, but when I do, I'll share it. Let's go to the next slide. All right. Not sure if our audio is working. I'm going to go ahead and play this clip and see if we hear anything. And you could let me know if we do by just putting on number one if you hear audio. I love the love. But can anybody hear the audio?
Doesn't seem like anyone can hear the audio.
Okay, good. All right. Well, we're gonna work with what we have. We're just gonna go lyric for lyric. This is gonna be kind of weird, but I think that we could probably still get to our points. Let's go to the next slide.
I'm just gonna give that another try. Hang on.
Okay. Oh, back in? Almost. Great. So just to review, we're going to listen to rap verses. And if you can't hear it, I'm going to rap it out for you where I can. Let's get a deeper understanding of some mainstream rap cadences and also some old school rap cadences. So we want to kind of combine the knowledge of learning how to interpret messages through music and also interpret the technical aspects of the music as we go along. And we'll make up some activities that you could use for your songwriting skills. Many of you that I've seen in here have been to my my other rap workshops from Bars and Hooks, Loops and Sounds, Intro to Hip Hop Culture. So some of this should be very familiar with you. For those of you who are new in the building, please type number one. Type number one if you're new in the building. This is the first time interacting with Coach Kenrick and the Hip Hop series. Then also, there's always that hope that you will take this seriously, be honest, and as always, let's have some fun. Let's go to the next slide. Okay. So this first song that we're going to break down. Oh, now I'm seeing everybody says no. There's a little delay on this. All right. So let me just revisit. Let's see if I can hear it. No. No audio was playing. So what we're going to have to do is going to do the song breakdowns as they are on screen. As long as you can see the screen, I'll go through it line for line. And then what I would like you to do is you're going to follow along in the chat box. If you have a pen and paper, I want you to write down some things that pop out to you from these lyrics by Tupac. All right. So the first song is called Holla If You Hear Me by Tupac. It's in the key of G, and its BPM is at 111, right? Now, as I go through these lyrics line for line, what I'm asking you to do is, the first thing you're going to do is, you see step one. Oh, are we going back? Oh, thank you. You're going to write down or put in the chat box any words or lines that you do not understand or don't make sense to you. The second thing you're going to do is write down any words or lines that you would feel would be unsafe for your classroom. And last but not least, we're going to highlight, so also write down any lyrics that speak to police brutality or stereotypes. Yes, I know you all can hear me, but not the audio from the presentation. We have a little bit of a sound glitch, so we're going to go through this as it is. All right, let's see what we can do. I'll try that. Someone said try taking the headset off to see if it works.
Hey, Kenrick, since my audio doesn't seem to be working for you, do you want to try and share it from your computer and we'll just go through it? Just take me out of the situation.
Hey, Kenrick, now we can't hear your audio.
Try just hitting refresh. Y'all are being so cool with this. Thank you.
How about now?
Perfect.
Yep, audio's back.
Audio's back in. Awesome. All right, let's see if I could screen share real quick. Technology. You gotta love it. You see my screen?
Yes, we can.
All righty.
Dear white Americans, you need to hear this even if you...
Can you hear that audio or no?
Can you hear that?
You can?
Yes, we can.
Oh, sweet. Okay, so we live then. All right, let's go. Let's get to it. All right, friends, compadres, I think we have sound. Let's move on. Oh, yeah. Yeah, now I'm hyped now. All right. Let's take a listen to Holler If You Hear Me by Tupac Shakur. All right, so we just went through that. Oopsie, we'll stop it right there and run it back. Those of you begin to start writing in the chat, what names, what lines or songs in the song did you find to be powerful? what connected to police brutality, anything that stuck out to you. Helen's saying getting dropped by cops. Yes. The line before that is to my homies on the block getting dropped by cops. Sign of the times, right? Funny, this was recorded back in 92. There is a lag on your comments, so I try to respond when I can. So excuse me if the volume's down, try to turn it up and stuff like that as we go along. All right, I'm going to go back to screen share mode, and then we're going to go through some tools that we could use to break down the music. All right, song breakdown toolkit. All right, so here's what we're going to do and how we're going to use it. First, we got a couple of things. Whoopsie. Technology, you got to love it. Got to love technology. All right, you got tunebat.com. That's a place that you're going to go to be able to find BPM and keys as quick as possible. You throw any song in there and it's going to show up. And then you have genius.com, which is also going to show you how the lyrics that are written, they'd be confirmed. They're confirmed by the artist, and they'll also be able to break down what the artist meant when they drop certain lines. All right. Also, obviously, to break down the song, you need your ears. Listen very carefully. Sometimes you'll have the words there for you. Sometimes you will not. And when you don't, sometimes you got to listen to it through. If you can't hear it, run it back. So I'm asking you also, if you hear anything throughout this slideshow that you want to listen to back because you didn't get the full experience through this, write down that name of the song and do your own due diligence. Go on YouTube on your own time and run it back. I promise you there'll be jewels and things you want to hear that you didn't get to hear. And then you also need your voice. Sometimes you want to approximate groove and know what the artist was feeling. Use your voice. Start chanting and using the choruses. Y'all know I'm always about game time, and I'm using that. Pen and paper. I'm old school, so I use a pen and paper to jot down whatever I need and use some creative resources. Sometimes I hear a line in a song that was dope, and I feel like I could put a different spin on it. So I might jot that line down, and it might inspire me to create a whole new song. Right. Last but not least, you need your restorative questions and feedback. What are restorative questions? Well, restorative questions and feedback, I kind of just coined this phrase. You know, we're going to ask why. We're not going to listen to these things and label them right away and try to figure out what the artist meant within the first two or three lines. Or if we hear a curse word and then it throws us off and we're thinking, oh, this, you're just talking about one thing. We're going to ask why certain words are used, why certain tones are used, why certain beats are used. And if we feel like we listen to something and it's not making sense or feels unsafe, offer solutions of how we can change that. Right? Here's that picture of Tunebat that I spoke about. Really easy. You go to tunebat.com. You type the name of the artist, song, or album. And as you can see, they go ahead and it's a quick way to find some key musical information. I just use Beyonce Love on Top as an example, C major. It's 4 minutes, 27 long, and it is a BPM of 94. Now, there's some other information that I'm not familiar with, and I'm not sure exactly how they came up with this, but I think it's just interesting to look at. So it gives you an energy rating, danceability rating, happiness, loudness, acousticness, instrumentalness. I'm not sure what that means. Liveness and speechiness. And shout out to anybody. Throw in the comments if you know what the Camelot numbers mean. What the Camelot numbers mean. I haven't found it useful just yet, but if some of you have, please definitely go right into the comments and let me know. Right. Genius.com is another one that we use. Well, whenever you're trying to break down lyrics or hear certain lyrics and you're not sure what that artist meant, you go to genius.com, you type the title or the name of the song in there. In this case, I typed in This Is America by Childish Gambino. And obviously it puts the lyrics up. And when you scroll over the lyrics, what it does, it gives you kind of like annotations. And if it's a punchline, it's referring to something else, it'll give you a little more insight on the lyrics to help your breakdown process go smoothly. Right. Now we're going to listen to another song and we're going to break it down in the chat group. This song I recorded actually this time last year. So it's almost like the 1 year anniversary of the song. It's called The System. And it has kind of my perspective of views on education at this point. So let's take a listen.
What are we gonna tell our kids, huh? Huh? Star, what up, man? You just want God to be with him. Malachi, Brandon, we want to speak for your mom, KJ. I'ma rap till I'm finished, I never had a limit. Grown men rapping like young boys, yes, we back to gimmicks. Kids growing up in classrooms, led by right purpose. Looking up to negative images, now they lacking wisdom. Corrupt system and funding is missing. School leaders fall victim to fake leaders and politicians. Fear of a black parent soon will come to fruition. Third grade test scores begin the pipeline to prison. What am I missing? The country in division, while the only music known to fight the system is focused on sipping, leaning, popping, twerking, blinging, banging, and killing. Leaving mama hurting from the bank to the kitchen, praying for overtime, hope there's leftovers for dinner. And then y'all have the nerve to tell us there's hope for our women. Left wing, right wing belong to the same plane. Does it really matter who lied if you lied to? Does it really matter who lied if you lied to? This is not by any means a call to do what I do. But I strongly suggest we use words where we have rights to. After school saved me, day school raised me. Principals like Susan Green influenced me greatly. Rachel Flynn, Mr. White's Woody with the hoodie. Redhead, Ressio, Dion, what's goody? Miss Maggie Carter Campbell kept me out of trouble. Support black business, build your brand and be humble. Too many sitting on the bench thinking change will just appear. Acting like LeBron can make black problems disappear. House sway. So let me get this clear. Superstars can cure our tears, but teachers didn't get them there. And if so, how is the pay fair? You can't count points, yard stats without math here. Or read a contract if literacy ain't near. I ain't knocking on the pros or showing any hate here. I'm addressing the system that just doesn't play fair. I'm addressing the system that just doesn't play fair. Huh? What are we talking about here, man? What are we gonna tell these kids?
All right, so that was The System. Please go into the chat and anything that you feel highlighted from those lyrics, please write them in the chat. Please write them in the chat. Anything you feel highlighted, please write them in the chat as we move on. Whoopsie. Let's go. All right. So this next video is by old school artist, actor, actress, revolutionary Queen Latifah. I don't know how many of you are familiar, but she put in a lot of work when it comes to social justice through music. So we're going to take a look at this video and we're going to do a little video breakdown. As you can see, the notes on the side, or if you're following along on a PowerPoint, you should be, once I play this video, what you should be looking for is writing down the names of any familiar faces or scenes that you see in this video. Again, any words or lines that you feel will be unsafe. Any metaphors, similes, or punchlines, and try to figure out what the main idea of this rap song is. All right. And remember, when you can't follow along or read because the lyrics are too small or the words are too small, try to use your ear and listen best you can. Let's take a look.
Those that don't know how to be pros get evicted. A woman could bear you, break you, take you. Now it's time to rhyme. Can you relate to a sister dope enough to make you holler and scream?
Yo, let me take it from here, queen. Excuse me, but I think I'm about due to get into precisely what I am about to do. I'm conversating to the folks who have no whatsoever clue. So listen very carefully as I break it down for you. Merrily, 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 high to happy, overjoyed. Please, with all the beats and rhymes my sisters have employed. Look, it's been throwing down the sound totally. A yes, let me state the position. Ladies first, yes?
Yes.
Ladies first. Believe me when I say being a woman is great to see. I know that all the fellas out there will agree with me. Not for being one, but for being with one. Cause when it's not for loving, it's the woman that gets them strong. Stepping, strutting, moving on, rhyming, cutting, and not forgetting. We are the ones to give birth to the new generation of prophets. Cause it's late. Break into a lyrical freestyle. Grab the mic, look at the crowd and see smiles. Cause they see a woman standing up on her own two. Sloppy slouching is something I won't do. Some think that we can't flow.
Can't flow.
Stereotypes, they got to go.
Got to go.
I'ma mess around and flip the scene into reverse.
With what?
With a little touch of ladies first.
My mind expands throughout the universe. A female rapper with a message to send. The queen Latifa is a perfect specimen.
My sister, can I get some?
Sure, Moni Love, grab the mic and get dumb.
Yo, praise me not for being simply what I am. Born in L-O-N-D-O and sound American. You take exactly where I'm coming from. You want righteous rhyme and I'ma give you some. To enable you to aid yourself and get paid. And the material that has no meaning I wish to place. Pay me every bit of your attention. Like mother, like daughter, I would also like to mention. I wish for you to bring me to the, bring me to the rhythm. Of which is now systematically given. Desperately stressing I'm the daughter of a sister. Who's the mother of a brother. Who's the brother of another. Plus one more. All four have a job to do. We doing it respect due to a mother who's the root of it. And next up is me, the M-O-N-I-E-L-O-V-E. And I'm first, cause I'm an L-A-Z-I-E.
Contact and in fact, the style it gets harder. Cooling on the scene with my European partner. Laying down track after track, waiting for the climax. When I get there, that's when I tax the next man or the next woman. It doesn't make a difference, keep the competition coming. And I recite you chapter in verse. The title of this recital is Ladies First. Civilization are on the mic. The scene is right, the crowd is hype. I expel the whack and those who bite. Why? Cause I'm that type. Swam with beats 45 King style. He wants me to sing, but I'll swing. So meanwhile, a footnote for the opposite sex. Moni, rip the mic, I rock it next. Plex, you never catch me at my worst. You get the drift? It's ladies first.
All right, that was Ladies First by Queen Latifah featuring Moni Love. All right, I'm just going to jump back into the comments and see where we at. Boom. Rhonda wrote, from the system, Rhonda wrote left wing, right wing belongs to the same plane. Absolutely, 100%. That was my in my writing, my idea is that the, you know, sometimes we get caught up on being extremely left or extremely right when it comes to politics. But to me, it's all about the same plane. We're all, you know, there's always an agenda. And when we think about, you know, trying to speak about our impression or try to fight for our rights, we have to understand that there's always an agenda and there's always an end game. So we have to always think about those things. Francesca said pipeline to prison. Yes. Ian also said third grade test scores start the pipe, begin the pipeline to prison. That's correct. I took a training a long time ago as a youth developer that kind of broke down how, you know, from third grade test scores, they kind of was calculating or using that information as part of the calculation process of how many jails to build, which I thought was eye opening. Address a system that just doesn't play for fair. Absolutely. I would like to highlight the thank you, Spence. I appreciate it. Left wing, right wing. I'm addressing a system that just doesn't play fair. Thank you, Lauren. Absolutely. As I started to write that song, the system with the first line, when I started to talk about, like, you know, how unbalanced our system is when we grow up trying to be young. Like, why does a rapper have to be 40 years old but want to rap like he's 25 years old to feel like he's relevant? Like, we should be able to rap our age and give messages to people our age. And that's a part of that entire Mr. Wagner project, was like, I'm going to rap as a 40-year-old black man in America with the stuff that I went through. And I'm not going to be talking about sipping, leaning, popping, and twerking, because honestly, it's not what my life is about. My life is about fatherhood. My life is about making sure that I know what to tell the kids in these classrooms. My life is about making sure that they feel safe, making sure that they can be their age and slow down the speed of life. You know, why should our kids grow up in a world where they have to be 20 years old in a 12-year-old's body? And everything that we do, every decision that we make, we have to continue to think about, are we letting our young people be their age? Are we letting them understand what consequences are? Or are we just pushing them out the way to be who we are or who we think that they should be? Only music known. Yep. So I want y'all to hold on to those great comments. Thank you for your comments on the system. I will be hopefully being able to give you a link so that you can listen to the Mr. Wagner album if you haven't already. So stay tuned to the end. Let's move on to the next video. And this one is called Black, right, by Buddy. Make sure that my screen is being shared. Yes, it is. All right. No.
Black on black, black. Yeah. Hey. Okay. Black, 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 black on black, black. My thoughts so black, black, black. I'm black. My skin is so black. I'm rocking that black on black. It's black rims on this black, black wheels in this black, black wheel with this black, black. So black on black on black on black on. Hey. Black out the coupe, hop out the roof when I run into you. Thoughts black as the dark side of the moon. Won't be no truce, won't be no truce. At your funeral in an all black suit. Couple white girls in all black suit. Me and man marching in an all black boot. Call up the truth, call up the truth. Put you in the mouth, then knock out your tooth. I can tell when they not telling the truth. Talking that nigga bitch gon' do. What you gon' do? What you gon' do? Back and I'm black and I'm black brand new. Niggas in the back like, oh word. Diamonds all black like, what you heard? What you heard? What you heard? Spilling some Hennessy black on the curb. Just for the memory of the deceased. When I black out, I'll awaken the beast. What it's gon' be? What it's gon' be? You don't want with a bitch like me. Bet you never seen my bitch so black. I'm black on black on black on black on black. Black, black, black on black. Black, my thoughts so black. Black, black, I'm black. My skin is so black. I'm rocking that black on black. It's black. Black rims on this black wheels. It's black wheel. It's black. It's black on black on black on black on black. Black, black, black on black. Black, my thoughts so black. Black, black, I'm black. My skin is so black. I'm rocking that black on black. It's black. Black rims on this black wheels. In this black wheel. With this black wheel. Black, so black on black on black on black. like Trayvon, with this black hoodie on, Huey P. Newton, black revolution, I'm with a Nubian queen, it's some illegal aliens, I got a black fist balled up, and it ain't just me, it's all us, 400 years of oppression, I'm about to give me that black Tesla. Black skid marks on the pavement, cops wanna see me in a black cage. Black on black on black, Master Juba with the tap dance, Gucci with the dapper dance, tell him kiss my black. Riding on a dyno with the black mags, just another black man trying to stay about the cask. Yeah, black don't crack, matter of fact, where the fuck are 40 acres at? We black on black on black on black on black, 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 black on black, black, my thoughts so black, black, black on black, my skin is so black, I'm rocking that black on black. Black rims on this black, black wheels in this black, black wheel with this black gear, black, black, black on black on black on black on.
I'll stop it right there. Go ahead and tap in the chat if you can. If you seen, you heard any familiar names, familiar faces, familiar dances. I see it. Okay, good, 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 good. I think we lagging a little bit, but we looking good. Nicole played old school Queen Latifah. Talked about this with the fifth grade and it blew their minds. Yes, very, very powerful video. It's a lesson plan in a video itself. You could go halfway through that video and have a lesson plan about just history, imagery, and women's rights. Moni Love is in the building. Yes. Somebody shouted. They saw Harriet Tubman, Sojourner True. Yup. Angela Davis. Yup. Yup. Absolutely. Unsafe. When you say unsafe, do you mean for me to teach in a class or culture? Do you mean from an admin's point of view? If I bring it up in class and kids go back and tell their parents, discuss what I get in trouble. Sandy, I would say to answer your question, I say unsafe, meaning that you as a person it would be uncomfortable to play that in your classroom. Either it doesn't really matter the reason, whether it's admin, whether it's you don't feel like they're ready for that, if you feel like the language is offensive, however you interpret it. Yep. Yeah, harmonies were dope. And ladies first. A woman can bear you, break you, take you. Powerful, powerful words. Not from one, but with one. Oof. I'm just loving the fact that a lot of you, thank you, Tag. Oh, Unk, the one in the three. He's keeping us grounded with the musical technical stuff. Thank you very much. It's so, you know, as music is so flavorful, and you know, it's always been my philosophy that the best music comes from pain, right? Because when you have that marriage of like just putting music together, having this conversation with these instruments, and then on top of the instrumental conversation, you have real conversations that are directed towards an agenda, a goal that's speaking out. It's so much to be learned. I think you can learn, you know, just as much. If I had this stuff on mute and you just looked at the imagery itself, it kind of just tells this story. Yep. Fists up, black power. Moni Love is dropping some Daz effects. Wait, ooh, I missed that one. Daz effects. Subverting the Kawa Shippers line, ladies first. Mm-hmm. Harry and Angela keep the competition coming. Yup. Lots of Kente print. Yup. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Spelling out the names reminds me of that culture conversation from Ashley's session yesterday. Wow, I'd love to get a snippet of that session. Yeah. And as you're typing in here and you're kind of just like describing this, you know, this painting, I feel like if I put all these words together, we could have such deep dialogue about all of the things that we're going through. And I feel like hip hop is just a great platform. It's not the only platform, but it's definitely a great platform because it's based on conversation. Hip hop is based on how you talk to somebody and getting your point across and figuring out what that angle is. And then all the other stuff like the punchlines, the metaphors and the hooks, those are things that could kind of like dress it and they catch it. But when you put it all together, it's just such a powerful platform. So I think, you know, when it comes to teaching your young people about rap, teach them how to have a conversation. Teach them how to identify injustice, identify feelings, teach them empathy, and teach them how to actually word and talk that out. Yes, Harold, we need role models. We need the Queen Latifahs of the world. We need to bring that back into hip hop. Aiden, thank you for that that link to the lyric genius. Agreed. So when we talk about, you know, what we're going through, you know, this hits home. This hits the classroom. It's always, I look at the world through what do I tell my kid? When something happens in the world today, I'm not worried about me because I made it past a certain point. I have to prepare my children for their next 30 years. So we have to learn how to take this information as leaders and as teachers and listen to it. And we have to do the work of breaking it down. We can't hear one curse word here, one curse word there, one line there, and just do away with the entire process of the music as if it doesn't have any substance. You want to listen to a song, well, a rap song, I'm going to say at least 3 or 4 times to determine whether it has substance in it that's useful or it does not. But that decision does not come from listening to it one time and skimming through it and thinking that you already know what this person is talking about, because it's deeper than rap and it's deeper than what you may think it is. Jabril, what's up, my brother? Yes, Black on Black. It's my favorite song because of the dances in there. The dances in there is insane. And, you know, I don't know if you guys looked or peeped it in the video, but they had like people playing some Black Icons. Yeah, Kerry, I agree. I would love to hear Kobe tribute, like a rap song from one of our people. Misty Copeland, yes, shout out. Yep. Let's move on to the next one. We don't have much time left, but we're gonna make use of it. So this next song is a song that I recorded not too long ago, and it doesn't have a hook. It's a straight through. I'm talking to you. I filmed a video called Relax, and there was a brave young man who decided to play the cop in this video. And as you can see in this imagery, I'm talking to him, and he has his hands raised, and all he can do is listen. That's all we want you to do. Listen. So let's take a listen to this song here.
Check this out, man. This is Mr. Wagon, man. And I don't need 3 minutes to make my point. We need prayer. Something. It's time.
Talk to him.
Systematic oppression, diplomatic aggression, put the country in recession. Consider counting your blessings. I politic with the politic, dancing around the answers. The country is under panic, from Washington to Atlanta. We witness all the distractions, manufactured the strategy. Global pandemic washes money through your policies. Honestly, a Black man, a virus doesn't faze me. Police, heart disease, are threats that could grave me. Mama tried to save me, sis died trying, cause we lived through a depression, ducking iron in the project, overworking, underpaid. I'm a product of pain, no trust fund, stock bonds, or foreign exchange. Miseducated and lazy, America eats its babies. They take our people for granted, acknowledge for only talent, then lock us up in the cages and profit from our behavior. Enslave us through legislation and tell us we need to change it. It's systematic oppression, I'm not the one for complaining. The revolution's awakened. It's time for us to create it and take control of our wages, instead of patiently waiting for saviors to come and save us and manage the situation. Take it just how you want it, my money nothing to play with, so take it just how you want it. I need it, I'm gonna claim it. Right.
All right, so that was Systematic Oppression. Definitely a song that I put a lot of my heart and soul into. And I wrote this literally right after the pandemic. I think it was like around March 16th or 17th. As soon as it shut down, it kind of spoke to me. Oh, well, as I'm reading through the comments, pardon me. I'll be going back and then coming up and trying to answer where I can. I think the curse words used in song, sometimes it is to get the message across more empathetically. I could agree with that. I feel like, and maybe that's not all the time in rap, and maybe it, but it, when it matters, right? Like there's some times where, you know, you put emphasis on something and, you know, expressing yourself vocally is the way that you do it. Not to say that it's right or wrong, but if we can understand where that energy comes from, then we can understand why it was written. I'm hoping to shift in the way that we think about profanity and educators. If we keep rap out of the classroom because of profanity, we are further marginalizing Black art and culture. Thank you for that that comment, Colin. I do agree with that to some degree. I do feel like there are things that are appropriate for certain levels of students. And I feel like we just need to be conscious. And, you know, I definitely agree that keeping rap out of the classroom would definitely do more harm than we are doing any type of restorative practice. What we need to do is we need to be able to extract the things that are powerful. And then we also need to be a little more student-centered by listening to what they're listening to and making sense of it instead of kind of imposing our ideas and visions on them. And I'm talking about the students. Mm-hmm. Yep. My kids are always referring to YouTube clean versions of some of the tunes that are not playable in the classroom. Yeah, you see, and that, and Harold, that's a great note to put. There's so much that we learn from the young people themselves. We can understand how to navigate around a lot of the things that bar us from teaching. Mm-hmm. Wow. Absolutely. Janelle, thank you for that article. I definitely want to take a look at that. So we can comfortably share elementary souls. I love this, the song. The other two songs, I would feel comfortable sharing those. Okay. Mary Rose, which song is it that you were saying you will be uncomfortable to share? Is that the first song, Holla If You Hear Me by Tupac? Or it's another one, please let me know. Mm-hmm. Francesca says, I understand some people's issue with language. I teach elementary. I allow students to let me know what they listen to and who their favorite artists are so that I may validate their musical choices. But I will always tell them I don't want to get fired for teaching. Yeah. Right. See, to me, I would say that's kind of like responding restorically or restoratively. I'm going to keep coining that phrase till we all say it. But, you know, it starts from the ask. You know, take the ideas from the young people. And then let them know what your expectations are, or let them know expectations before that. They know what the expectations are. They know there are certain things that they can't listen to in front of their parents, or they wouldn't want to play. They wouldn't want their younger sister or younger brother talking about mollies and stuff like that. And even though for them it's enjoyable because they may like the beat or like the song, doesn't necessarily mean that everybody's ready for that. So it's about kind of just navigating that person. Right. And just not putting the attention on just the offense or offensive language that you see in it. Mm-hmm. Zaneta says we should be mindful about labeling dances as sexual. We should. I agree. And mindfulness means that we're asking why, we're figuring it out, and we're trying to understand it. I totally agree. I think the only thing that is separating us from, you know, how we address certain situations is how we address it. Like, how are we actually asking these questions? How are we actually putting discipline into practice? Are we letting the student be a part of that practice, or are we going straight to disciplinary, meaning we're going straight to action and we're putting a bar between us as leaders and them as students? It's a collaborative process. And as a teacher or leader, you're the guide. How do you not circumvent the importance around the words that a lot of parents, oh my goodness, this chat goes so fast, it's hard for me to catch up. Maria, I got clicked over to yours, and yep, in some cases we want to be able to put out some formal information saying that we're doing this project. And again, it's the conversation, it's the navigating, it's saying this is why we're doing this. This is why we are doing this. And we hope that you would understand. And by signing this, you understand. There's no clue that we are, like, especially, you know, teachers that's on the wave that we're in with the student-centeredness, with the pop culture, like, we're on the wave of disrupting what is traditionally the norm. And there's so many discussions that we could have and so many fingers we could point about why things are the norm and why they are. But do we really have the time to do that, or are we about to be about that action? That's why I got this shirt on. Action over captions. Actions over captions, right? Are we just going to type and leave it there, or are we going to follow up with some action, music, culture, how we teach, how we learn, how do we include, how we navigate, how do we think outside of the box, how do we ask for permission, right? How do we ask for permission? And in many cases, it's the students and their families that we ask that permission for. And chances are, if you're on board with that and you come from a place of care and engagement and love, they're willing to have the conversation. I got about 5 minutes left. So what I do want to say is, you know, I know we had a little bit of some mishaps here or there with audio, with visual. I would like to actually do this PowerPoint again on my own time with you all. So I'm going to put my email in the chat box and just email me if you would like to take this workshop again, and we'll figure it out. So y'all hearing the systematic oppression. When I wrote that, I had chills. Let me tell you, I had chills. Take our people for granted, acknowledge for only talent, and lock us up in the cages and profit from our behavior, enslave us through legislation and tell us we need to change it. It's systematic oppression. I'm not the one for complaining. The revolution's awakened. Yes. That's all real talk, y'all. It's all real talk. Mama tried to save me. Sis died trying. Because we went through a depression, ducking iron in the projects, overworking, underpaid. I'm a product of pain. No trust funds, stock bonds, or foreign exchange. Yes, Zanetta, we have to create the revolution. Miseducated and lazy America. Ooh, I'm sorry. I might feel like I'm hyping my own stuff, but I'm really excited because I really got to speak my truth on that track. Great rhythmic anticipation in your rap. Really funky. Thank you, Andreas. Systematic Oppression is not on Spotify yet. The other song, The System, is on Spotify. Shoot me an email. I'll put my email in the chat again. Shoot me an email. I need access to your album. I'd like to take the workshop again. And we're going to make it happen. Liza, you could get all my tracks on Spotify. It is Mr. Wagner Music. Mr. Wagner Music. And search that in Spotify, Mr. Wagner Music, and you'll be able to find the name of that album is The Maturation of Mr. Wagner. And you'll see it because it has a picture of my two sons. Where do you drop your songs, Kendrick? I found these on Spotify. Okay, yeah. Yeah, the only song that you're not going to find on Spotify that you've listened to today was Systematic Oppression. I didn't even finish mixing that. I was so happy to put it together. So Systematic Oppression will come out all. Powerful Words and Imagery, Systematic Oppression. Particular song isn't on Spotify, but The System is. Yes, The System is on Spotify, yes. Right? A Prodigal Pen. So, right. So, like, you know, when I write these lyrics, I don't attack or kind of like target any, you know, group of people. I just speak about what I see and what I experience. And you could quote me on this. I truly don't believe that the word white supremacy lives with white people itself. I feel like that is an idea. That's a thought that is in certain people's head and they move a certain way. Thanks to Jabril. It's a white ally. We want us to support the first movement. Felicia, I appreciate you. And thank you for that comment. I am working on a website soon. Oh, my time. They about to cut me off. I am working on a website soon. Call Actions Over Captions. I promise you, as long as you stay on the emails with me, you shoot me an email. For one, you'll get the PowerPoint. We'll do the workshop again and schedule time to do it. And then for two, you'll get a lot of goodies of stuff that I'm working on the background. I'm so constantly active sometimes. My workshops don't catch up with the work I put in. I want to thank all of you for joining me today for this. This was just a short amount of time for so much more. Please stay in touch with me. Shoot me an email. Let's make something happen. Thank you very much. Please fill out the evaluation and give me a very honest feedback. I appreciate y'all. Take care. Have a good one.